faster running to get the snackies because I am terrified of getting out of my car. Like, I drive a BMW, not that it's like super high class, but I swear to you right now, it's like, I don't mean this to be like racist, but okay, well, it's gonna come out racist anyways, but there's just these six really scary looking guys, and I think they'd be scary whether they were white or black. But I mean, I love black men. I have many relations with black men, but these black men look like they're gonna kill me. So I'm just hoping my sister makes it alive. I'm a terrible sister because I did not go in with her, but she's very conservative today, and she's got mom jeans and a sweater on. So she looks very cute. I didn't mean that as a slam. So she's gonna get snackies because, well, you're gonna have to go watch her vlog because we're gonna film them, but she found these snackies that we used to have back in the Midwest at this gas station. So not knock in the ghetto because they have really good snack food. So hopefully my sister makes it alive and we'll see what snackies she got.
So this is a bit of a throwback clip of Trisha Paytas, who's a well-known influencer, is going viral right now on TikTok for singing songs. But Paytas is a self-confessed troll. Paytas has admitted that some of their more outlandish videos were posted just to get the clicks. They told Business Insider their support of Romney was one of those cases, as was a video where they claimed dogs don't have brains. On her YouTube channel, she faced accusations of yellow face along with a multitude of different controversies like her dating history, music, faith, and politics. Her notoriety would land her a stint on Celebrity Big Brother UK. So this is how she became famous, but it's dangerous rhetoric. I mean, what she's talking about there, these black men look dangerous, and thankfully my sister is wearing a more conservative outfit, mom jeans and a sweater, as if she would be in danger if she wasn't. And to start the video off with, this is going to come off out as racist. Nothing good follows that sentence. And she even admits, you know what, it is gonna come off as racist. Maybe then you are being racist. And if she's just doing it for clicks, it doesn't matter. The effect of the words are still exactly the same. And it's just a reminder that these ideas live rent free in people's brains, including Trisha Paytas. And she knows it's gonna get clicks because there are people out there who agree with her. And this kind of rhetoric being passed around emboldens those people. It's not enough when we have the rise of fascism in the United States to simply say, well, I'm not being racist. You have to be anti-racist. You have to say when someone's being racist that that's not okay. Because if you don't say anything, you're basically sending the message that you're okay living in a society where racism is running rampant. And here she's perpetrating it. Dina, I want to bring you in here. What are your thoughts on Miss Trisha Paytas?
Well, I think your commentary was right on. I mean, she purposely, obviously was purposely being racist because she wanted the controversy. She wanted the clicks. I mean, come on, President, you know, Trump did this perfectly, right? He said the most racist things, the most outrageous things because he wanted the attention. And you know, this, you cannot get around that in this day and age. Like, anybody can be a content creator, anybody can post any video. And it's true that the more kind of outrageous it is, sometimes the more attention it gets. And so we as individual consumers, I mean, absolutely, as you said, we need to be anti-racist and speak out. But also as individual consumers, we get to not view that video. We get to not, you know, retweet, even if it, you know, we want to put our own spin on it. Like right now, our most powerful weapon as a content, as a consumer, is like silence and giving that no attention. It seems, you know, maybe like not enough, but it's actually quite a lot. If a collective large amount of people give silence to somebody who's purposely racist, you know, then they don't get the clicks they want.
Yeah, I think that's key, right? We vote with our attention when we're consuming content. We're telling the algorithm by viewing a significant portion of a video, just by watching, you're telling the algorithm, this is a good video and this is the kind of stuff I want to see moreover. And that's a huge problem. So it can be tempting to watch the rest of this video when she starts it off with something so inflammatory, but it's much better to just swipe up and scroll to the next video so that you don't tell the algorithm this is the kind of content that will succeed in the algorithm for other viewers. And so it's gonna show it to more people if you watch the video. It's not enough to just not like and comment it. We're voting with our attention, is essentially, with these algorithms. Any last thoughts on this, Dina?
You know, I think that's right, and it's hard because sometimes it's like a train wreck, and you want to watch the train wreck, but we can't watch the train wreck. Otherwise, we're just going to be. What are we going to be like? It's going to be full of just really racist comments and also just really mean comments. You know, we can all kind of bring that temperature down by just like you said, just swiping up and not even finishing it.
Yeah, and it might seem contradictory, right? Like these two points, like you have to be anti-racist, but you also have to actively ignore this, right? You have to suppress the content by not giving it your attention. But then how do you send an anti-racist message? I think you could say something like Trisha Paytas is, you know, using spreading racist sentiments to get more views online. So when you see her videos, don't watch them. You can tell five friends that. I promise you, Trisha Paytas's videos are coming up on everybody's TikTok feed, including mine. And if you tell them that, that's something that's powerful, right? That spreads a message. That's how you can be actively anti-racist and also ignore the content itself.